Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. As I'm a lecturer in metallurgy, metals, I haven't studied theology. So I got a new skin. And if your mind is clear, then you can brew the new wine. If your skin is old, as it created in the universities, where they teach the Old Testament and the New Testament, all by the letters, then you are done. You cannot be retrieved unless you prepare a new skin. And that Jesus demonstrated at Cana. When the old wine was finished, he asked the servants to clear all the traces of old wine from the vat and then fill it with fresh water. The vats are these our physical body, so you should take off all the old ideas, what you have studied. And then fresh water means a unbiased heart. So you have a heart which is unbiased and clear thinking, clear water, fresh water, clear thinking. Then you will brew the new wine. Now Christ Thomas went to India, and over there he said, unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. Now this saying, somebody tried in 1984 or so to decipher it. They could not. They wrote about 20 pages article with no conclusion. They just beat about the bush. And I did explain to them that unless you have Christ in your heart, you cannot be a man. But they won't understand, because gospel comes by grace. So if you are longing for gospel, then it will come. If you have no desire, it will not come. Now this saying is related to Christ Jesus when he started his ministry after feeding the 5,000 with heavenly bread. Then he said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. Now that was the beginning. And the people who were following at that time, 5,000, they were Jewish people, men of letters. When he said, unless you eat my flesh, flesh of Jesus, and they say, this man also cut me into pieces and eat me, something go wrong with his head. So they all left him. Same as Nicodemus was told, unless he is reborn, he cannot understand the things of spirit. So then he said, shall I go back into the womb of my mother again to be reborn? He took a literal sense. So men of letters, they take literal sense. Unless you are a person of spirit who exercises common sense, only then, you will understand this saying. Eating the flesh of Jesus is that in the beginning was the word can't speak because it has no mouth, no flesh. It is abstract. So that's why it had the flesh of Jesus. And he lived among us. And he preached gospel. So what came out of the mouth of Jesus when you understand, you have the ears to hear, and you take it to your heart, and you digest it, understand it, and then you have eaten the flesh of Jesus. And when you preach it from your mouth, then you drink the blood of Christ. And not everybody can do it, you know. I give you a very simple and very basic example. A Jew is one who is inwardly and not outwardly. So spiritual self, not the physical self. So the physical self that died during the Holocaust, they were not Jews, but of Benjamin tribe, Judah tribe, Levi tribe, tribal people born, they died at the Holocaust. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, and let a so-called pastor, a dog-colored hireling priest of Mammon, preach this simple truth, gospel truth, in the pulpit. And you will see how he is thrown out, how people will make you and cry. 4 million died. You say, no, nobody died. But they have not been told that Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self. Physical self is are the tribal people, tribal selves, which are Judah, Levi, Benjamin, and so and so. They were born, they died. So when you can preach gospel with authority, then you are not under the sway of anyone. Then, like the born blind person of John 9, whose eyes Jesus opened with spectacle, he was independent person, solitary. So he had inner man, his inner man was speaking, or his Christ was speaking. So such a person is solitary. He is not under the sway of his parents, of rabbi, or anybody. So such people are independent, and they are the masters of their own destiny. Such people are male. So those people who are stooges of the church, dog-collar priest, they tell them, don't read any other gospel than the four they have been prescribed. So if I tell them, have you read Gospel of Thomas? They will say, hey, our priest say, don't read it. So we haven't read it. So such is the situation. You need to act independently, because you going to give your account to God, that priest can't. So if he stops you from reading other gospel than what you have, then he is antichrist. In fact, the dog-colored people are antichrist, because they are hireling of Mammon, and to get rid of them, Christ Jesus gave his own sacrifice as the Lamb of God. So be alert and be on your own footing, that you become by eating the flesh of Jesus and by drinking the blood of Christ. Drinking means preaching gospel from your own mouth. Gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper. gospel come from your own mouth. And if you are not twice born, but you are dead, or once born person, then the book knowledge will come from your mouth. This man says, oh, Daniel says so, this man that nonsense will come, and you will have no confidence what you are saying. So that is what we call a female, or she is subject to certain rules and regulations, as a book may be ruling him, you know. For example, in some churches you go, if you tell the priest here or the people there that the name of the prodigal son is Isaac and of elder son is Ishmael and father is Abraham, they will say, it's not written there, so we don't believe it. They will reject it outright. Such people are slaves of the book, which is dead letters. The living in spirit are the living Christ of our living Father. So we preach gospel with authority. So that's what it means, that when you get the understanding of gospel and you preach, then you have Christ in your heart. Or you are the master of your own destiny, or you are a male, not a female anymore. So unless a female means a person who do what his priest tells him to do, that is, he is a slave. And so when he's a slave to his priest or bishop or anything, then that person is a female, because that priest or bishop is not going to give your account to God. You have to give your account to yourself. So it's what comes out of your own mouth that matters, and not what this man say or that man say or Bible says. You know, Bibles are dead letters. Without spirit, they are more dangerous than good. People can make corruptions. The Jewish people are well known for corruptions, and that is what Jesus said, you cannot patch the old cloth, which is the Torah, with the brand new cloth, which is the New Testament or Gospel, because they are not compatible, and the patch will become worse. And that is what happened. The patch mean that people are not understanding the subject. If you ask the general public, if God is spirit, then who created Adam and Eve? So I bet hardly anyone knows. So this is the standard of theology at Oxford University, and so are in the other universities, because they attend their lectures, and when I ask simple questions, they have no answer. So do not sell your conscience to a rabbi or a priest or anyone who put on anything, but keep yourself independent and go by the Christ in your heart. Whatever he says, do it. He won't mislead you, because there is no greater a teacher than Christ himself. So when you understand the word spoken by Christ, then you have eaten the flesh of Jesus and you have become part of Jesus, body of Jesus. as the body has different limbs which have different functions to perform, so in the Church of God we have people who have different capabilities, and together we work to bring the loaf, the woman hid, three hid leaven in the three layers of flour. Three layers are the Trinity people, helic, psychic and pneumatic. And it became a big loaf, one Church of God, headed by Christ Jesus. And then when it was ripe, then it was taken away by our Father as sacrifice. So always go by your own understanding, and then you have to give your account to God. Not any priest or anybody is going to give your account. So think about it, because in Jesus the temple of God, which is our physical body, is more important than these brick-built temples created by rich people or rich countries, and they are creating problem too. So I hope that I made my point clear, and our Father God blesses you.